and he's much matured as a gymnast. Oh, yes. Now that's going to be the best mark so far. That must be the best mark of the morning. Just a sign there that everyone approves. He really spotted it beautifully. Control, magnificent flight, pushes off, turns, and then spots it without a movement. Beautiful vault. Ten. First ten of the competition, and the crowd are rising to him, and he acknowledges that, and the competition has really come alive. It's taken two pieces of apparatus in the compulsory exercise to find the first ten of these Olympic Games, and what else could the judges do? And the noise in the background, the vault that we missed from Lu Yun. Super run, high drive off, holds the position perfectly and lands it beautifully. Another 10 for the Chinese. Next on high bar, the 16, Zhu Xiaquan, the 21-year-old from Guangdong. Quing receiving the plaudits to the crowd for his 10 dead on high bar. An immaculate performance. The third 10 of the competition, all of them going to the Chinese. Next up, Tong Fei. Now the flyaway, that hecked. Oh, they've got it off marvellously. They really are covering acres of ground. Tong Fei, now he's seen Zhu Xiaquan score 10 on high bar. One wonders what we're going to see when we see their voluntary exercises. And of course the judges, having seen a perfect score, if there are no faults in this, they have nowhere else to go. They would have to give that score, and indeed they do. Tong Fei scores 10, the fourth in the competition. There he is. And the Chinese are excelling in the compulsory exercises. And Kuchikin receiving rapturous applause for a 10 on high bar. Crowd love that. And here's Shinji Morisu to follow that. This is the one piece of apparatus where, if they were to come back, Japanese would score slightly better than the Chinese, although there's such a big gap now, it's almost beyond their reach. But that's another lovely performance from Moritsu, the 27-year-old, taller man, 5'7", the elegant gymnast. Some of the girl gymnasts here can see how much taller he is than the other Japanese there. Kajitari. So hopes rise, and they're right. Japanese camp elated, they've got a second 10. Gutchikin, now Moritsu. Two tens for them. Leading, had to wait a while for his score, but on pommels, whilst Morisu was scoring 10 on high bar, he has scored 10 on pommels. And Li Xiaoping has to follow that 10, but he shared the World Championship gold medal on pommels in 1981. He is really a pommel horse specialist. This soccer fan from Shanghai, another tall, 5'7½, lovely lift, swinging from the chest rather than from the hips. Look at the height in those sheer legs. Not a lot wrong with that. I think he agrees. And could that be a pair of tens leaning, leaping up to congratulate him? And it is. Pair of tens, Li Xiaoping, matches leaning. And they're really cock-a-hoop. Marvellous compulsory exercises, the best we've ever seen in an Olympic Games or World Championships. So after the first session of six exercises, China have established a pretty massive lead, really. 294.25 points to Japan's 292.48. France have 287.65, but of course the American challenge still to come.
Magnificent Pauley Pavilion here at University College of Los Angeles, generally referred to as UCLA. And you can just see walking out onto the 12-meter square, Terry Bartlett for Great Britain, the 20-year-old from Southampton, studying at American University at Penn State. British team looking for an average of 9.5 for a total of 285 in the compulsories, which will be their highest ever score in a major championship. Nicely done. Untidy on the balance. Now the closing routine, which finishes with an Arabian. Spotted nicely. It's Terry, whose parents are here in the audience to see that. He is a floor specialist and he's done well. Mitch Gaylord, the last of the Americans on parallel bars. Very polished. And the first 10 goes to the American Mitch Gaylord on parallel bars. Tim Daggett, 22-year-old, Springfield, Illinois.
makes you think he's practiced that.
Emotions running high in the American camp. They'll never have a better chance to get a team gold medal than this. They had a bronze medal in 1904 and a silver medal in 1932. No team medal since then. But their scores are piling up, and that's another 9-9. So a lot of responsibility on Peter Wittmaar now. He must score well to keep their average up. Working well. He's got it. That's my job. Done well, he says. The Americans will remember this. And it's 9.95. He's patched up all the gaps, if there were any. And they're still ahead of the Chinese at the same stage of the competition. And this was Terry Bartlett's superb vault. He really was in cracking form for this. The drive and determination, and he really flies. Look at the height he gets there. Spots it beautifully and scores 9-9. Bart Connor. Designed by Japanese. The technical difficulty is in the linking between the hoops. Nicely done, best we've seen. Yep. Elephant press. Nicely done too. Get his landing right, he's on for a good score. Yep. Brilliant. All right, they're saying. And they're right. .95 has gone on the board for Bart Connor on floor. So one judge at least gave him a 10. This is Wittmaar. And the judges decided this was faultless. He really did motor through it. Yes, indeed. Well, that's the sort of reception the American team have got, because the scoreboard shows that at the end of the set routines, their total is 295.3 to the Chinese total of 294.25. So they've more than a point in hand. Japan in third place, 292.4. They meet again for the voluntary exercises, but all look set for the Americans to get one of the top medals.
Well, there we are. That's how it stands. As you can see, after the compulsory exercises, United States and China and Japan, and in fact, Britain ended up in 9.